Welcome to the Spy Collection. This is Anastasios, and for this episode we have a spy artifact from World War II. Starting in 1943, the Emerson Radio and Phonograph Corporation produced a miniature spy radio receiver as part of a US Navy contract. Those were the RBZ receivers that were shipped in this pouch that you see here. The most well-known use of those devices were during D-Day, the Normandy landings, where Navy personnel was using them to receive instructions. As you can see, it's a very simple design. This is the battery unit. This is the radio receiver. And this is the headphone. Both were waterproofed, considering that they were designed for maritime operations. Here is a diagram indicating how they are connected. Let's do that. And the design was exceptionally simple. Just a knob for the frequency selector and another one for the gain that was also acting as the on-off switch. We aren't going to dive into the design and internals, but just for completeness, here is the battery unit. And here is the radio receiver. There is a far more detailed article available online in the Crypto Museum. As always, links in the description. If we'd like to highlight one quite innovative solution to keep them compact and user-friendly, is that to avoid having another component separately, the antenna, the engineers designed a clip that was attached to the back of the helmet of the soldiers, and the metal helmet body was acting as the antenna of the radio receiver. And now that the general concepts and history behind it are clear, let's talk about its lesser-known espionage history. According to former SAS signals officer Nobby Clark, Britain's SAS, including himself, used the RBZ during Operation Handsworth. Their compact size, low weight and robustness, having been designed for maritime operations, made that an ideal clandestine radio receiver to receive encrypted instructions without the threat of detection, since it was only receiving, not transmitting. For those not familiar, this was an SAS A squadron operation behind enemy lines in France of 1944. 18 officers and 126 operators of the A squadron of the 1st SAS infiltrated by parachute inside the Nazi-occupied France. They established a covert base southwest of Dijon. From there, they started conducting covert operations to disrupt the German lines of communication and supplies. They blew up keep rail lines 22 times and started building a spy network consisting of French resistance groups. Usually, after each successful covert operation, they were sending their French agents to pretend to be local people worried about the damage to assess the impact and talk with the repair groups to learn how long it would take for the lines to be operational again. They also identified 30 targets for Royal Air Force interdiction, captured 132 prisoners of war, killed or wounded 220 Germans, and derailed 6 trains. The operation lasted for exactly 4 months, and it was one of the very successful covert operations of the British SAS. Apart from the SAS operators that used them, as we described during Operation Handsworth, such devices were also provided to key French resistance operatives so that they can listen to BBC broadcasts. Even to this day, the RBZ is considered as a very successful clandestine radio receiver for its time. And despite its initial intention as a US Navy one-way communications device, it ended up having a history in the espionage and covert action world. It's not uncommon for spy agencies and covert operatives to adopt technologies designed for others, but it is a nice example why nothing is as it seems.